friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome if you are new here. It is a Friday and I am coming at you from my brand new car. Well, not brand new, but new to me. So you're going to be seeing a little bit different background in my upcoming weigh-in review video. So I'm here. It's Friday. It's 6:30. I just pulled into my WW workshop. I have a very busy day today, so I'm excited to come in, see what the topic is, weigh in, and move on with my busy day. I wanted to share with you guys a little bit about my week this last week and how things went and kind of what my expectations are when I go to step on the scale today. So my week was good. I wouldn't say that my week was fabulous, stellar, great, but my week was good. I did not get to Jazzercise as many times as I wanted. I ended up only going twice this week. Buying the car fell on this week, so that took up another evening. And then I just haven't been feeling the best the last couple of days. I've been really fatigued and tired, and my stomach has been feeling a little bit sore the last couple days, including today. So I did not get to Jazzercise as often as I wanted this last week, and I'm still sore from when I did go. So I don't know if I'm getting sick and my body's fighting that off, but I'm just not feeling 100% this last week. So Jazzercise kind of went to the back burner just because I didn't want to go work out when I wasn't feeling that great. My food was pretty good. I had a couple of higher point days, but then I had some really low point days, like the evening we bought the car. I didn't even eat dinner because we were at the dealership until 7 o'clock. So it just was hit and miss this last week. But overall, food-wise, I had a pretty darn good week. So I'm expecting a loss on the scale. I would imagine that I would have a loss. There wouldn't be any reason that I wouldn't think that. And that would be my fourth week in a row that I've had some sort of loss on the scale. So I'm off on a good streak that I want to maintain. So I'm going to go ahead and head in, weigh in, stay for the workshop, and I'll be back to share with you guys not only what we talked about, but also my weigh-in. Just got out of my WW workshop. What a fantastic topic. It is something that I know that sometimes I struggle with. I've definitely gotten better with it in the new year, as it was one of my goals, and that is tracking. Some people love it, some people hate it, but no matter who you ask, whether it be a WW coach, a guide, a fellow Weight Watchers member who's lost a lot of weight on the program, tracking is absolutely essential to success. That is why WW put tracking as part of the must-dos to be successful on their program. So I'm going to share with you some tips today from WW on making tracking easier. So number one, let's say that you are out to dinner somewhere, or you're at a friend's house and they prepare dinner or lunch for you, and you're not 100% sure what is in that meal as far as ingredients and how much of those ingredients are in that meal. The number one tip for tracking is make your best guess, especially if you're out at a restaurant and let's say that you're ordering a 6-ounce petite sirloin steak and it is not on in the app for that particular menu. Just type in petite sirloin steak, pick the general steak, select your ounces that your portion is, and track that. So just make your best guess. We're not always going to know exactly what is in all of our meals. We're not going to know exactly what is in a meal from a restaurant or even a meal that a friend or a family member prepares for us. So the number one tip is don't skip tracking altogether because you don't know what's in your meal. Just track to your best possible guess. You may be a little high, a little low, but it's all gonna work itself out in the wash, and it's better to track than track nothing at all. Number two is plan ahead. So if you know that you're going out on a particular night for a meal, or maybe you know that you're going to have a higher point or a splurge meal during the week, plan ahead and pre-track it. That way you know exactly how many rollovers you might need every day to make that happen, or weeklies that you need to save up, or maybe you need to eat more zero-point foods that day so that you have enough to go have that special meal or that splurge. So it's best to kind of plan ahead and know what is on your menu for the week that may be higher in points so that you can then accommodate that particular menu or meal during the week with rollovers, zero-point foods, and weeklies. Number three, take advantage of your app. WW gave us the app to help us be successful. Use your barcode scanner, but just be cautioned that not the barcode scanner is not always 100% accurate. If it seems too good to be true, or even if it seems like that particular item is a little higher in points than you anticipated, use the calculator in the app, enter the nutritional information, and you're gonna get a rock solid 100% true answer to the number of smart points in that item. Over the last couple of weeks, I've found several items that scan incorrectly, that the points are actually more or less than scanning. Number one is those Quaker rice cakes that I picked up at Costco. Those were scanning way higher in smart points because the serving size was wrong in the barcode scanner. Another thing I found just this last week was my Clio Greek yogurt bars. They're actually scanning 1 point less than they really are for the 5 point bars. They're actually 6 points. So better safe than sorry. Enter it into the nutritional calculator if you're questioning the barcode scanner, or actually enter everything in the calculator that you scan to make sure that it's accurate. Another thing, your very favorite things, do a recheck, rescan them, re-enter them into the nutritional calculator to make sure that the points remain the same, because sometimes points on our particular favorite foods change. So be better safe than sorry and just use your barcode scanner. You can even use the microphone on your phone and say the item that you want to know the smart points for, and the app is smart enough to pop up the smart points for that particular item. So take advantage of all of the great features on the WW app. Number four is something I would have never thought about, but it is such a fantastic tip, and that is take a picture. If you are somewhere where you just can't sit down and track that meal right then and there, take a picture of what you ate so that it's a reminder for you to track it later. What I would recommend is take a picture and text it to yourself, because how often do you go into the gallery per se on your phone, but you do read your text messages regularly. So I would snap a picture of my dish and text it to myself, and then I would track it at a later time. So take a picture of your food if you're unable to track it right then and there. I really truly love this tip. Number five is track with curiosity. It is completely okay to have a higher point day, a higher point week, a higher point meal, but track it just so you know exactly what you are eating. So in the future, maybe you would or wouldn't make that same food choice again. So today is a prime example of this. My really good friend who attends my workshop with me, she came in and she said that on Saturday, she had a 98 smart point day. She tracked everything that went into her mouth and it was 98 smart points. And once she tracked it and looked back over it, she thought, I literally ate nothing of substance or nutritional value that day, and it was 98 smart points. So lesson learned for her that she maybe wouldn't do that again. Maybe she'd select one or two of those items, and then the rest of the food for the day would be more nutritionally dense for her rather than just crappy food and snacks. So tracking out of curiosity is a great thing, because it's better to know the points of what you're eating so you can decide whether or not those points were worth it. And number six is another great tip, and that is watch for patterns. Get to know your tracking style. Are you tracking every day? Are you tracking in the morning and then you slack off in the afternoon or the evening? Look back over the last few weeks or months of your tracking and see what the patterns are. That way you can learn what you want to continue doing and maybe what you want to do a little bit differently when it comes to tracking. We always can learn from our past mistakes or our past successes to decide what we may or may not want to continue doing in the future. So again, what a fantastic topic this week. I've been pretty good with my tracking. My personality is very type A, so I like to track and write things down and make lists. So tracking isn't really a struggle for me, but like I've mentioned before, I start to struggle as the day goes on. I'm great in the morning. I'm great with my morning snack, even lunch, but once the afternoon or evening hits, that's where I start to slack off in my tracking. So that's why it's a goal for me this year to really honestly track every meal, good, bad, indifferent, track everything. So hopefully those six tips kind of help you learn how to track a little bit better. So let's move into this week's weigh-in. Like I mentioned when I went into my workshop, overall, I feel that I had a good week. I didn't get in as much jazzercise as I would have liked, and my food was kind of hit and miss, but most of the time my food was good for this last week, and I was anticipating another loss on the scale. So with that being said, when I stepped on the scale, I was actually up 1 pound. And let me just tell you how undeserved I feel that was. There have been weeks where my eating and my exercise has been far worse and I've lost weight or maintained. So I'm a little bit annoyed and frustrated that I had a 1 pound gain, because there is absolutely zero reason for me to gain a pound this week on the scale. So a little bit disappointed, but also I want to now figure out why that happened. Was it just a fluke with my body? I am a little bit sore, like I mentioned. I haven't been feeling very well. Like, what is it that caused that gain? Because I really truly don't feel that it was deserved. I feel that I should have had a loss this week, maybe not more than a pound or so, but I still feel like that should have been a pound lost, not a pound gained. So lesson learned for me to not expect a loss every week on the scale, but I'm going to take that this next week and I'm going to kind of reflect and see what maybe would have caused that pound gain on the scale. And I'm not going to let myself get down about it. I'm going to pick up this week with a great anticipation for a loss this next week and do everything I can this week to see that loss next week. So speaking of that, I'm actually heading to Jazzercise right now. I'm going to be doing the 8 o'clock class this morning, and that just gets me off on a great foot for the week. I'm going to go to Jazzercise again tomorrow. And then I've also decided, based on the tracking topic of today's workshop, I'm actually going to track on Saturday. We are going out to dinner at the Texas Roadhouse. I'm going to have what I want to have for dinner, but I'm going to track it and I'm going to see exactly how many points I eat on my non-tracking or the day that I use my weeklies, just for fun, so that I can reflect back, kind of like those tips shared, and see maybe if that could be contributing to my lack of larger weight losses every week, or maybe exactly what is involved in that. So I'm gonna do that this week. I'm very, very curious about that. I also have in my mind kind of rolling around a kind of test week that I want to do, and I'm curious how that is going to work out as well. So I'll be sharing that with you guys down the road. It's going to be kind of a trial and error that I'm gonna do for a week and see if it changes the results on the scale. So I'm really excited for that. It's kind of an experiment that I wanna do here a little bit later on, maybe in the month of February. So of course, I'll share that with you guys. So, not what I expected when I stepped on the scale. I'm not going to let it get me down. I'm going to go sweat at Jazzercise and burn off that stinking pound. But I want to hear, how was your guys' week? Was your weigh-in what you expected? Do you feel that it was deserved, undeserved? What do you think about this tracking and what these tips that WW shared with us on how to make tracking just a little bit easier? So make sure you leave your comments down below. I love hearing how your guys' week went. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I do a weigh-in every single Friday. So make sure you're subscribed and you hit that little bell so you're notified whenever I upload a new video. You don't want to miss out. Thumbs up this one if you love these weekly weigh-ins. And of course, leave those comments down below. I can't wait to read about your guys' week. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful Friday and I'll see you next time. Bye. What's it like to be the one that he turns to when he's